I'm back with part two of this sermon of Jacob and Genesis 32. And Jacob wrestles with God. And as we can see beforehand in Genesis 32, we can see where Jacob is concerned. He's praying to God. And this is where the encouragement for us to pray. For us to pray. We can see here during the night, Jacob had got up and took his two wives and his two servants' wives and his 11 sons across Jabbok River with them, and after taking them to the other side, he sent over all his possessions. This left Jacob all alone in the camp. A man came and wrestled to him until dawn breaks. Excuse me. And when the man saw, that he would not win the match, he touched Jacob's hip and wrenched it. It was out of its socket. Then the man said, "Let me go, for the dawn is breaking." But Jacob said, "I will not let you go unless you bless me." So Jacob was being very persistent. He was hanging on. With all the struggles and the need to find our own identity, and when faith lives, we all have stories to tell. We all have our stories to tell, but here where Jacob was being so persistent, he was hanging on. When the man saw that he would not win the match, he touched Jacob's hip and wrenched it out of its socket. Then the man said, "Let me go, for the dawn is breaking." But Jacob said, "I will not let you go unless you bless me." So Jacob was saying to the man that he was wrestling with, "Let me go," but he was saying, "I will not let you go unless you bless me." So Jacob was asking to be blessed. So we all are struggling, and we need to find our own identity and where our faith lies. We all have our stories to tell. God allows to overcome our struggles and our questions of God and life. What is our identity? We are seeking and searching for who we are. For who we are. Jacob was not willing to give up. He was hanging on to this man. He wanted to be blessed. Jacob was deadlocked with this man. God was in flesh. In the morning, daybreak was coming. Jacob was not willing to give up, hanging on to this man. He wanted to be blessed by God. So as we go on, "And what is your name?" the man asked. Verses 27 of Genesis 32. He replied, "Jacob." "Your name will no longer be Jacob," the man told him. "From now on you will be called Israel, because you have fought with God and with man and have won." So we see here that God had changed Jacob's name to Israel, because you have fought with God and with men and have won. Jacob was wrestling with God, Jacob meaning the grass of a hill of a kind, with the saying, "the deceiver." Israel's meaning is "he who scribes with God." So Israel's meaning is he who scribes with God says, "This is it, Jacob, your name is now Israel, and a new life has begun, and you can move forward." Then God blessed him. So it's like that when we decide to give our life to Jesus Christ, and we are wrestling with the world and we're wrestling with things, and we hear the calling of God, and we hear the calling of God on our hearts, just like Jacob. But we're not wrestling like Jacob was wrestling with God, and was that close to God that he decided to wrestle with God, and he was struggling, and he wasn't willing to give up until he was blessed by God. That shows commitment. And it's like we are wrestling with the world and we are seeking our identities. We're seeking an identity. Jacob was wrestling with God, and Jacob meaning the grass of the hill, a kind with the saying, "the deceiver." And because that Jacob was wrestling with God, as it says here, "because you have fought with God, with the man, and you have won," "I'm pleased to tell you your name," Jacob said. "Why do you want to know my name?" the man replied. "The blessed Jacob there. Jacob names the place Peniel, which means the face of God. For it is said, I have seen God's face to face, yet my life has been spared." The sun was rising as Jacob left Peniel, and he was limping because of the injury to his hip. Even today, the people of Israel don't eat the tendon near the hip socket because of what happened the night when the man strained the tendon on Jacob's hip. The face of God. He was wrestling with the face of God. The problems that we face, we do not want to get close to God. We do not want to get close enough to God to struggle with Him in prayer. We never get too close enough to God. We keep our relations with God. We need to have our personal space. Because we need our personal space, we never get close to God. Oh, we're happy going to church. And we never get too close to God because we are happy doing other things and we are limiting what God has in store for us. We limit the things that God has seen. How do we meet God today? Do we meet Him in spirit? We meet Him in spirit. That's how we meet God today. We meet Him in a spiritual sense. We meet Him in spirit through the Holy Spirit. And it is not in flesh, like what happened to Jacob. Our struggles, we meet God in prayer. Our struggles, our wrestles are in prayer. We wrestle within prayer. We struggles, and our struggles are in prayer. Jacob was wrestling with God, and Jacob meaning grasp of hill. So Jacob was meaning the grasp of hill, saying deceiver. Israel was meeting who scribes with God, says this is where Jacob, your name is Israel, and your new life has begun, and is more, and now you can move forward. Because God had changed his name from being a deceiver and a sinner, and actually deceiving and plotting and doing all these things, as we can see in Jacob 1 down, Jacob 32 verses 1 down to 21. He's deceiving, he's a deceiver. He's got these thoughts in his mind. He's praying to God, as we can see in my brother. We can see this. So in 32, in verses 9, then Jacob prayed, "O God of my grandfather Abraham, God of my father Isaac, O Lord, you told me, return to your own land and your relatives. And you promised me, O Lord, and told me, return to your own land and your relatives, and you promised me, I will treat you kindly." The problem is that it is a struggle within prayer. As we pray to God, and in this event that happened with Jacob, the struggling that happened, as Jacob wrestled with God, the struggling and the wrestling with the life of trying to get by and struggling in the life that can struggle on the wrestling match in life, we can see that the event with Jacob and God wrestling, it made a big impression on Jacob's life, remembering that his name was placed Peniel, which is meaning the face of God. His limbs were firsts for the first of his life. He had a limp because they had ripped from his hip joint. He had a limp for the rest of his life. So the thing is that it is our prayer that we need. We need to have faith in God that our prayers can be answered. We need to focus on what it is all about. And we need to focus on God. And the thing is, we need to be that close to God that we are wrestling with God in prayer, in the spiritual realm, in the spiritual sense. We are wrestling with God in our prayers. But obviously, as it says in Genesis 32, in Genesis 32 to 1 to 21, he was more concerned about his brother Esau and what he was going to do. Does this make sense, church? That he was more concerned. Don't we get to the point of being human that we say, oh, but person's going to say this, this person's going to say that. And we struggle with praying. We struggle with God. We struggle to surrender to God and struggle to give it all to God. And what happens is we can see here that Jacob in verses 9 of Genesis 32, verses 9, then Jacob prayed, O God, my grandfather Abraham, and God of my father Isaac, O Lord, you told me, return to your own land and your relatives, and you promised me. He said, God promised me. God promised Jacob, and I will treat you kindly. I'm not worthy of the unfailing love and the faithfulness you have shown me to your servants when I left home and crossed the Jordan River. I own nothing except my walking stick. Now my household is filled with two large camps. We can see that in Genesis 32, 1 to 21, we can see here that there is doubt. And Jacob is struggling with prayer. Jacob is struggling with praying. He's praying to God, and he's struggling because he's so close with God. God is about to discipline Jacob, and God is about to test Jacob. God is about to question to Jacob how committed he is. And it shows that we can see that Jacob was that close to God, that Jacob wrestles with God. And we can see that during the night, Jacob got up and took his two wives and two servants and his 11 sons and crossed the Jabbok River with them. And after taking them to the other side, he sent over all his possessions. So here we have Jacob in Genesis 2 to 1 to 21. He has in his mind this mindset. He's struggling with prayer. He's struggling and wrestling with prayer and struggling and wrestling with God. And he's concerned about what his brother Esau's going to do when he arrives. He's concerned and he has all these thoughts and doubts in his mind. But really, at the end of the day, church, can we see a pattern here happening? Can we see a pattern happening here? We overreact today. In our world, I overreact. We all overreact. We push buttons. And what were the buttons that Jacob pushed? What was the buttons that Jacob had pushed? What was the overreaction to try to counteract the thought in Jacob's head that his brother Esau may be nasty to him and cause trouble? He overreacted and counteracted with doing this. He divided these animals into herds and assigned each to different servants. Then he told his servants, go ahead of me with the animals, but keep them some distance between the herds. He gave these instructions to man leading the first group. This is verse 17 of Genesis 32. When my brother Esau meets with you, he will ask, whose servants are you? Where are you going? Who owns these animals? You must reply. So when my brother Esau meets with you and he asks you these questions, you must reply, they belong to my servant Jacob, but they are gifts for these master Esau. Look, he is coming right behind us. Jacob gave the same instructions to the second and third herdsmen and all who followed behind the herds. You must say the same thing to Esau to meet with him. So the gifts were sent on ahead while Jacob himself spent the night in the camp. So these gifts were sent ahead while they spent the night in the camp. Suddenly Jacob, his two wives and his two servants' wives and the 11 sons were sleeping in the camp. And what did Jacob do? Jacob woke up suddenly in the night. Jacob got up, took his two wives, his two servants' wives and 11 children and crossed the Jabbok River with them. And after taking the other side, he sent over all his possessions. He sent all over his possessions, his two servants' wives, his two wives, and his 11 children. And this left Jacob alone, vulnerable, and in a sense that he was on his own, alone in a camp. A man came and wrestled with him until dawn began to break. When the man saw that he would not win the match, he touched Jacob's hip and wrenched it out of its socket. The man said, let me go, for the dawn is breaking.